All right. Got some blood on it. Guess I hit my knuckle on this edge. Anyway, I was pounding this in. You see, I put a dent there. Right there, it ain't moving because it's up against some serious steel back there. So I'm gonna have to get a band-aid on my knuckle. But let me show you what I did here also. I put some flathead screws in here just to hold all this stuff together, because that was kind of messing with my brain cell. So now I can see a little bit better what I got to deal with down there or up there. I think what we're going to do is, I think what I want to do is take some wood off this thing if I can. Right in the area of that bump. Where are you? Right. I've got like a quarter inch on that very tip right here. I don't want to make that razor thin, but I'm just saying that I've got some leeway. So I'm planning on doing a little bit of a scribe job on this. Don't know if I'm going to be successful or not, but I can pound that in right there just a little bit. That'll move. And then get this line a little bit straighter right here. And then I can put a scribe on this to mark how much to take off of this bevel side here. And I'll do that with a belt sander. And that'll alleviate some of my problem. Oh, and also since my last piece of recording, I trimmed the edge of this piece. So now it's more or less along the whole edge. It's finished edge where it's going to be. So I could see a little bit better what's going on behind it. Alright, this thing's been kicking my butt here, man. What I've been doing is, I started out with my belt sander and all the belts were just old and the damn seam came loose. And, every one of them, even the brand new out of the package. I guess they just were too old from sitting around. I don't know, man. I mean, I actually took them out of the package and they were bad. I'm not gonna buy those anymore. What is this? Gator Power? Never heard of them. Anywho. So, yeah, I was using my dad's block plane. You see all the wood I took off. So, I'm close to 60. And I would say my father had this before I was born. And I'm sure they don't make them quite like this anymore. What a jewel. I put a new edge on it. And cuts like magic. This is red oak and it's going right through it. So anyway, let me show you what I did. It's I'm pretty happy with it. I mean, it's as good as I'm going to get anyway. So let me I mean, I could keep working on this and make it a little bit straighter. So down there at the bottom, like the bottom, I don't know, 8 inches or so, I got about a 16th of an inch. You know, there's a little bit of a hump right around here. And I just got done taking off some from the behind there. And right over here, we got a hollow. So it's there's a hump right in this here area between this line that I drew and over here, and over here on this side, you can see how thin it is right there, and where it's touching pretty hard right there. And these areas are a little bit in the air down there, but that's okay. I could fill that with the Gorilla adhesive. So what I found out my biggest problem was that the angle cut on the back of this needed to be cut more, because the juncture between the straight side on the back and the angle was too far in, and it was causing this thing to rock. So it's in there like swimwear. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to take it back off again, and I'm going to smooth out this edge, because this is just a table saw cut, and it's also curved, so I mean, it was, you know, it's pretty rough. So we're going to smooth that out, and all I've got is the block plane and a vibrator sander. Then I would like to round off this edge with the router, put like a 1/8 inch radius on it. I think I'm going to save the radius. I'm not going to do that yet, just in case my plan changes here, what I want to do for trimming on the outside of this. Because, I mean, it would look kind of neat if I glued a little trim on the front of this to hide some of this here, but I know I don't need it. So now, with this in place, I mean, that's good. So now back to this edge down here to make the door. Let's see how it turned out. Let's just say there's a door there, right? It's the bottom of the door. You can see that there's hardly any angle to that, because this guy now sat in there a little bit deeper. Gee, that's just a couple degrees. Let's flip it over the other way and see if it's the end of the... Yeah, it's still... I mean, that's really close to being flat. All I gotta do is make sure my hinge can, if I use a conventional door hinge in there, just have to make sure that my hinge is set to the enough that it can close tight enough and not bind. Thumbs up on that. So now, the next steps here, I mean, this is where it's going to go. The aluminum plate that I have sitting right there that goes on top of this bottom step, I'm going to have to cut down here to make way for it. And you can see how crooked that is. That's this that's crooked, not this. That was cut with my table saw. That's a 90 right there. So this thing's kind of whacked out. Okay, so if I get that piece of aluminum in there, then I can permanently install these. And now I gotta think about how I'm gonna do this, because I've got these screws. These are sheet metal type screws that I don't have access to the back side of. Okay, so my choices are stay with sheet metal type screws, or thread those, and that's not going to be a 1032. So that's the next challenge, is working on this side. All right, so I didn't think this was going to work, and it's still kind of marginal, but I took out these sheet metal screws down this whole line, and I threaded them with 1032, and it looks like There was just enough metal in there to allow me to thread those things. I don't have a 1032 screw here, except for one. The second one from the top up there, the hole size was a little bit too big, but here's what I learned, that this, where the heck did you go, man? There you go. I've only got like an inch, and I can drill further in there. So it's, you know, this piece here, it's, and then there's another piece of metal. There you go, that piece, and then this. So that gives me, at least for this one, a second shot. I'm gonna drill in there. And, I guess before I'm gonna drill in there, I'm gonna give it a shot with a regular machine screw and see if it holds. But when I put the tap in there, it kind of was just wiggly woggly. But I'm not gonna need much really, because this is flat and straight. And all I gotta do is, flat and straight. All I've gotta do is cut a piece of this 1x material, the same width as this. Stick it on there. So I got all these. I want to transfer these into the wood. And I already revideoed this once, but just in case I've lost that video, I'm going to show you what the tool is for that. The transfer punches. Where the heck are they? Right here. Now this one is looks like 5/16, and made in China. This one is 1032. This is what I'm looking for. Okay. So what it is you take this cap off the back, and inside here. Look like set screws, but the wrench end is not a hollow Allen key, it's an external hex. Okay, and you screw that in the hole, and you use the tip of this as a wrench. So then you, when these are screwed in the hole, you're left with this point. And you could put whatever you want to transfer up against it. In this case, that piece of wood. And you tap it with a hammer, and it puts a punch mark exactly where you want it. So the method I'm going to use for this is I'm going to do one at the top and one at the bottom. Mark it, punch it. Put the screw in there, and put these in all the other holes, and put the two screws in it on the one on the top and the bottom. Then the piece of wood will be in there right where it needs to be, and then I'll be able to mark these, and they'll be exactly where they need to be. So let me get into that. Oh gosh, I can't believe what I just did. So I came over here and I measured this. I guess I did it over here. It's like, all right, 4 3/4. And I went and cut the piece of wood that I already cut once and glued back together. Right there. And what I forgot, I guess I'm tired. I forgot that the bus is not straight up and down, that it's fatter. This piece of wood is fatter in the middle, and it's really, its fattest point is like 5 1/4. All right. So I cut that piece of wood 1/2 inch too small. Man, I mean, if it was a piece of pine, that would be one thing, but Jesus, This red oak's expensive. So I gotta do it again, man. I'm gonna cut myself a piece of plywood, get the router out, and cut a groove in the end of this thing and glue that piece back on again. God dang it, what a pain. All right, man, so putting this thing back together, I feel like an idiot. So I cut a groove. I just used the table saw to rip it. And this fits in there. A little bit loose in some places, but that's all right. Leaves room for the glue. So I dug up some scrap pieces of this Luon plywood. So we're all ready here. The table saw's got these grooves in it for running a miter deal in there. 3/4 inch. It comes in handy when you're working a 3/4 inch wood. Hold it for you just nicely. So yeah, this is a fresh rip cut right here that I did when I cut this piece off like a damn idiot. So I'm just gluing it right back in its same place. So any irregularities in that cut will just line up. Gotta get some glue. There you go. So the stuff here is getting kind of thick, but it's still good enough, I guess. And get myself a little paintbrush. Get one of these deals over here. Right, so if you want to know a nice trick to making these things way more usable, take a scissor. See if I can do this. I'm holding the phone with my chin. I don't even know what I'm aiming at here. Alright, sorry about that, guys. So time will tell if that video, I actually took a video. So I just grab a hold of the end of the bristles and then I use a scissor to cut the bristles a little bit shorter. And these little typewriter brushes or acid brushes, whatever you call them, they work a heck of a lot better when you cut them short. So I'm gonna get my clamps out. I got 3 of those guys. These are really nice clamps made by Bessie. I was a little disappointed when I bought these. Got them on Amazon, like I do a lot of my stuff, but the flat right here wasn't perpendicular to the bar. You know, the clamp would go crooked on you. It's like really bad, man. But luckily there was like a little rise in the casting and I was able to machine that flat. You can see where I machined it years ago. So I got 3 of those. Had 4. One of them left there. And I gotta double check that those things would go wide enough. This and I got a couple of more clamps. I think they're down here. Yeah, these guys. So that I should be good with the clamps. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna put a little bit of glue down in the groove, just enough to get it wet, but not enough that it'll cause a hydraulic lock and this thing won't go in there. Then we're gonna take the paintbrush and get this thing wet, stick it in there, put it together. All there is to it. You guys probably seen this before. So yeah, here we go. Okay, we're ready to assemble. I already put my spline in there. Jesus, my hands are dirty. I put an extra bead of glue on both sides of the spline, and I've already got glue down in that groove. I just put big old long bead of glue inside the groove there and smeared it around with my paintbrush. So now we're gonna put this together, clamp it, and call it a day. I'm beat. Don't want to make any more mistakes. And here's what she looks like. I think I'll take a towel and scrape off the excess now before it cures. Yeah, maybe I'll just let it cure. Yeah, we got a good squeeze. A little bit light on glue. I would have liked to see a little squeeze out here and over here, but this thing ain't going nowhere. Let's see what the side looks like. Yeah, we got a good squeeze. Alright. Match up and it's sitting straight. So, I mean, if it was bowing, I could have clamped it down to the table saw to make it flat and put some pieces of angle metal across here or something, but it's good enough. Oh my gosh. Alright, now we're going to clean up. My little woman's made us BLTs and tomato soup. It's a gorgeous day. I wish I had more energy.